In this video, we're going to be going over the free distort feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics. Here I'm just going to make a copy of this text, right click on it, and then create outlines. What that does is it turns it into basic artwork, so it's just anchor points and paths. This text up here is still live text. Go back into normal mode, and next I'm going to come to the top, find the effect menu, and in here you're going to find distort and transform, and click on free distort. That's going to bring up this free distort panel, which is the free distort effect that ships native in Adobe Illustrator. In this window, you can click and drag on these different anchor points, and it's going to make changes to the text. Now, you don't see these changes being updated on my document, but when you click OK, you see it takes care of it there. Now, if I want to make edits to this effect, I have to come over here to the appearance panel, find the effect, and then I can continue to make edits in here. I'll just click on these anchor points, drag them out, and when I click OK, you see it's updated here. I'm going to undo that a couple times and then hide the appearance panel. Next, I'm going to come over here to the stylism panel. This section here has all the different effects you could apply using stylism. While I have my artwork selected, I'm going to click on this free distort, and you see it applies the free distort right away. I can click and drag on these annotations, and when I release, you see my text is being updated. So I'm just clicking and dragging to get these different looks. Now, as I'm dragging along, I'm just freely distorting this, right? But if I introduce a shift key, you can see I'm actually constraining it to the angle that I already have defined here. So if I wanted this bottom angle to stay true, I'll just click and drag and then introduce the shift key. And you see it'll stay right along this text for me. Every time I hover over one of these annotations, you see I get some information that pops out. That's letting me know the exact location of this annotation. So if I wanted to specify exactly where I wanted it, I just have to double click on it. And in here, I could enter the X and Y coordinates. When I click OK, you see this annotation has been relocated. Now, as I've been playing around with these annotations, I got this little crosshair that pops up. So this crosshair is actually the vanishing point. So it allows me to make the edits keeping this vanishing point in mind. So this is really going to help speed up my workflow. All right, let me just move this guy here. Great. Now, because this is a live effect, I could actually come back to the original artwork and start making changes. So I'll just click on this text again. And this time I'm going to select these anchor points over here. Now that I have them selected, I'll make a change, and again, because this is a live effect, you see that the change takes place right away. All right, so far we've just been dealing with outlined text. Now what I want to do is show you how we could apply these same effects onto this live text. So while I have it selected, I'm going to come over here to the stylism panel and then choose free distort. Again, I get these annotations. I can click and drag. And you see it's making these edits for me right here. Now, because this is live text, it's important to mention that sometimes you're not going to get very accurate results. If I drag this annotation out this way, you see this M actually goes outside this bounding box. The behavior I would like is for it to actually go along this angle here. But that's just a result of the free distort effect that ships native with Adobe Illustrator. So if you need this to be more accurate, I would go ahead and outline my text first. But if it's more important for you to have live text, I would go ahead and just kind of work around that a bit and just continue to make adjustments. Now, one of the great things about having live text, you could activate your type tool, double click on the text, and then input some new information here. So there you go. I'll go ahead and accept that. And you see I've added this new text here, but it actually still has the effect that I applied to it earlier. And that's how you use the free distort feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics.